have television royalty here, Ryan. I mean, I'm excited about it. She is Tampa Bay television royalty. It's absolutely true. Gail Searns is here from News Channel 8, formerly of News Channel 8. Yes. You retired back in, what was it, 2015 you retired?
It was longer than that. It's been a little over 3 years.
3 years.
3 years in May.
Okay.
So, yeah, a little longer than that.
The dream that we're all looking forward to.
Exactly.
Retiring from broadcasting.
This is a really fun gig, this retirement thing.
But you've done so much here at the hospital. You've hosted or co-hosted the annual telethon for 31 years.
Yeah.
Talk about that experience and then what this hospital means to you.
I don't really think there's anything quite like it. I mean, we were exhausted. We were on our feet for many, many hours. And, you know, it was a show. And people were coming in and out. Those people who came in and out of my life during those telethons are still people that many of them I keep up with, that I know and love. You know, you watch these children from very sick babies, and they come back the next year, and they're a little healthier, and they come back the year after that, and suddenly they're walking and talking and starting to do. It is, every bit of it is a miracle. And just to be part of it, to experience it and watch it happen before your eyes, as we did with this telethon, was just a blessing for me. I really miss it. I do.
I'll bet you do. You meet so many fascinating people,
you
too.
You do.
And the families, and you grow close with them, and just like you said, seeing them grow up.
The stories, and you know, we were doing story after story about how these children did find their way to All Children's, which is what it was back then when I was doing it. Now, of course, Johns Hopkins All Children's Hospital. But, you know, the stories of the doctors and the nurses and the care that they received, none of that has changed. If anything, it's gotten even better. And it's just a wonderful hospital, and we're just so blessed to have it in our community.
Well, and she's been doing double duty because she, you know, co-hosted a telethon, but you're also on the board, too. So yeah. You're like a giver. You're like a double giver.
Well, I am now. I'm on the board now. That's part of my retirement.
Oh, okay.
That I wanted to be on this board, and you know, it's an opportunity to see a little more from the inside out of what goes on and how things happen, and I'm even more impressed now. You know, I was impressed when I wasn't on the board and looking from the outside in. Now that I'm on the inside looking out and knowing how a lot of the things get done, I'm even more impressed. So it's just a wonderful place.
We were joking on Instagram that 31 years co-hosting the telethon, and we said, this is your first time joining us on Radiothon, even though we've been doing it for 10 years, and I loved your answer. You just said, you didn't invite me.
Nobody asked.
Nobody asked. No?
I would have come.
I'm just on the other side of the bridge. I can get here pretty quickly if the traffic's good.
I love that.
We're talking to Gail Searns. She, of course, co-anchored News Channel 8's 5, 6, and 11 o'clock. What were those days like? Were those the longest days ever, doing three newscasts every single
It was for a while. First of all, my first 9 years, I was a sportscaster.
Yes, of course.
And so those were really fun years. Big transition going from sports to news, because now all of a sudden, you know, you're talking about a whole different subset of issues in the world, from, you know, your favorite team losing a game to, you know, all the tragic things sometimes we had to report. But I just really felt like having that job for as long as I did was a real blessing for me. You know, the people who I got to meet in my life, the stories that we got to cover, not a lot of them, you know, something you'd be very happy about.
Yeah.
But that just to have been part of some of those times in our community, it was just a great gig. I had a great run at it. I was delighted to work there as long as I did, and I was equally as delighted when I decided I would retire. I gave them 2.5 years notice that the gig was going to be up, that I was going to move on and start playing more golf. And
Are you spending a lot of time at the beach too? Yeah.
I don't spend much time at the beach. When you have skin like this, you really don't.
Yeah.
The freckles are all still here, and the skin is getting thinner as I get older. But I do spend a lot of time golfing, and I'm still involved with a lot of different things in our community, which make me very, very happy. And I have all three of my children, grown children now, all living back in the Tampa area.
Oh, wow.
And one's about to get married in February. So we have our first wedding. So life is very full and very wonderful right now.
And one of the things she does so well is gives back to the community. And of course, as we mentioned here at Johns Hopkins All Children's Hospital, she's here today to help us. If there's one thing you could tell our listeners right now, why should they call right now and make a donation? What has this project over the years of co-hosting the telethon and now being on the board meant to you? And what's the real reason that you would encourage people to donate today?
I would say the exact same thing I said on that stage for all those years that we did the telethon. And that is, I pray that you never need the services of this hospital.
Yeah. Absolutely.
But I thank God that it's here.
Yeah, absolutely. A lot of people think about you. If you have healthy kids right now, that's a reason to call.
That's a blessing.
That is a blessing.
And that's a reason to call.
Absolutely.
And I absolutely feel that way. I mean, we all of us hope you never need it. I needed this hospital. My oldest child, Cam, who's now 29, was born with severe pectus excavatum. And that is a very technical term for he basically had his chest so sunken in that if he went in the pool or the bathtub, it would hold water. We would have to take a towel and dry it out. And they did chest wall surgery here. He's got a nice little bell curve scar that, with his manly hair on his chest, now you can barely see.
Yeah.
And, you know, he is a healthy, functioning 29-year-old who plays sports, who played college sports, you know, who plays soccer today on a men's team. And, you know, he's just a healthy kid. And so I had a firsthand experience at this hospital, and I know how it works. And it works. It works. It's a great place to have in our community. And hope you never have to have it.
Absolutely.
But
if you do,
thank God
here.
It's here.
Yeah, absolutely. 1-800-270-8642 is the phone number. Phone bank is open. We're there waiting for your phone call. And I think Gail said it best because it is true. I mean, and Ryan, you have a young daughter. And I think if you're a parent listening right now, you think about, boy, I really hope... Because I think you worry, right, as a parent?
Yeah. Oh, my gosh, that's all you do as a parent is worry. Are you kidding me?
Especially
that's
when,
all you do.
Watching the news.
Exactly.
And you
combine watching the news and having children, it's pretty scary. But yes, we're just so fortunate to have this hospital here in our community. You know, people come from far away to get the kind of care that they have here. And we're just so fortunate and blessed to have it here. You know, for some, it might be as far away as across a couple bridges. But, you know, at the end of the day, that's not so bad.
Not so bad at all.
No.
If you want to be a monthly Miracle Maker, the other thing that's great is it's easy to donate. I always think that that's the best part, is that $15 a month, 50 cents a day, I mean, everybody can really afford that, especially with the holidays coming up. When you think about, you know, the money you're going to spend on eating out or doing other things, that this could really make a difference in a family or a child's life. So if you want to be a monthly Miracle Maker, we'll take it. Even if you want to donate a dollar, we'll take it. We were talking about this. Yeah. What's the Metro, the Tampa, St. Pete, Clearwater metropolitan population?
Oh, gosh, I don't know.
3.5 million, I think,
or
something
like
that.
It's grown so tremendously.
And we were really thinking, like, if it's, let's say it's 3 million. I don't know because I don't work for the Census Bureau, but let's say it's 3 million. If every single person gave a dollar, we'd have $3 million today.
How about that?
You know what I mean? Every cent counts. Every dollar counts. Everything counts. So if you're listening right now and you think, I can't really afford to give, you know, the holidays are, you can. With a dollar a day, you can.
Right. And you know what? What better time to give than during the holiday season? You know, this is a season of giving. This is the season where we should think about other people more than we think about ourselves. And as I say, my personal experience was, yes, I was fortunate enough to work on this telethon for years and years. And then when I needed it the most, when I had a child that had a situation, a condition that needed to be repaired, I mean, thank God it was here, and the doctors were here to be able to do that kind of surgery, and then I didn't have to take them somewhere else.
It's an amazing story. As we're kind of reading your stat sheet, just looking at all the great things that you've done.
I don't know about that.
They listed out for us. Just you know, just being a football guy. I want to ask you about being the first woman to do play-by-play for an NFL team. Like, what game was it? What year was it? What game was it?
It was Kansas City Chiefs, and it was awesome. It was 1980. I know 87 because I was pregnant with my son Cam when I did the game. It's kind of a blur, to be honest with you, because I was pregnant and doing this game. Where, truthfully, I've never had so many people pressed against a piece of glass to see what I was doing in my life. It was Kansas City, Seattle. It was just an amazing experience for me that I loved. I'm so happy that I did it. I'm so happy I'm not still doing it.
Retirement does look good on you.
You know what? And the thing is that I would have loved, at that point in my career, I would have loved to have kept doing it. But when I did that football game, I actually was in the news at that point. Mm-hmm. You know, I had switched from sports to news. And so my bosses, who had just spent all this money to try and get people to forget that I was a sportscaster through promotion and things, they weren't all tickled pink when I did the football game. And I get that. So I had a decision to make. The decision was, would I forego my regular job, or, you know, as a news anchor, or would I try to pursue being a sportscaster again for the, my second time around? And having myself pregnant and about to start a family, I decided I would do the safe thing and the thing that I loved also. It wasn't like I didn't love it, and stay with Channel 8 and continue to do the news. And that's what I did, and it worked out just perfectly.
It did.
Just
it's,
fine.
It's a good thing for us, because now she's here helping us at today's Radiothon.
And helping with, the hospital
and
the
helping
board.
The hospital and the board. So 1-800-270-8642. A Cares for Kids Radiothon presented by Caliber Collision. Thank you so much, Gail.
Well,
it's
thank
just
you,
wonderful
Beth. Thank
to
you all
you.
For what you're doing here for this Radiothon and the fact that you know that you have a real appreciation and love for this cause as well. So thank you.
We almost got you to sneak it in there and say the wrong one.
I know, I almost did. Well,
it's like old times.
After years of that, doing that, you know.
Say. All right, thank you so much for stopping and sharing your thoughts with us. Let's get you on the phones here before we get out of here for a few. 1-800-270-8642. 1-800-270-8642. We want to make you a monthly miracle maker if you can step up and do it for just $15 a month or 50 cents a day. 1-800-270-8642. The great gang from Crossout Cancer and employees here from Johns Hopkins All Children's Hospital waiting to take your calls on the phone. 1-800-270-8642. More from Johns Hopkins All Children's Hospital. Our US 103.5 Cares for Kids Radiothon.